It says, "Glory to God in the highest." Give me five. Thank you, sir. And rejoice. That's Luke 2:14. And rejoice, for Jesus Christ was born that we might have new life. We have put our hope in the living God, who is the Savior of all men. 1 Timothy 4:10. This Christmas card says, rejoicing with you in this holy season and his, and wishing you a blessed Christmas.
She crossed it out.
No, mira,
Yeah, why would she cross it out? This is unusual. All right. I know she was a religious person. Oh, she's still alive. Please read what it says.
Have a Merry Christmas and a
prosperous
New Year
to Anna
and Danny and Maya.
So this tells you what year it was. This was in 2000. No, it doesn't say, but she sent it by mail, P.O. Box, right? And it says 2002. You see that on the stamped stamp? Larnsey Rowe and family. Her husband already passed away. She's just a little bit younger than grandma. But you know that this lady, you never know who you're going to meet. She met Rosa, my mother, when my mother was in the hospital. She was working as a nurse. But then the other nurses were saying that you gave the pills were missing in the hospital? So this tells you the pills were missing. And the other nurses said, you gave it to the patient, remember? So she got out of that business because they were accusing her of giving pills to the patient and the pills were actually being stolen.
Max,
yeah?
The Roblox game, did it work?
Nope.
When you took off the thing?
No, it didn't work.
Dang.
So eventually, she helped your mother buy a condominium, and then your mother sold it, because I talked her into selling it, and your mother received $101,000. Alright? That's when we moved up here. Now, we're going to read. It's about, the topic is, ¿cómo disfrutar del trabajo duro?
That's not where we're on.
We're at number six, son. But they have given you six things to do.
Okay.
So that you can enjoy your hard work.
I thought I already read number six.
That's right, you did, but I didn't record it. And he hasn't read it.
What about number five?
You both read five the day before, or the day before that day before.
Right.
2 days ago.
Then why didn't you check it?
Because I didn't have a marker with me.
You should have bought the scissors and markers for me.
When I am more organized, I will. And I do have them. They're in the room. Mantenga el trabajo en su lugar.
Mantenga el trabajo en su lugar.
Aunque
trabajar mucho
es
admirable.
Recuerde
que eso no es
lo único
en la vida.
Es cierto que
la Biblia
nos anima a ser diligentes. Proverbios 13:4. Pero
no a
convertirnos
en
adictos al trabajo. Eclesiastes 4:6
dice
mejor es un puñado de descanso que dos de duro
trabajo.
¿Cuál es la lección? Es muy probable que un
trabajador
empedernido
Nunca vea
el fruto de su labor, Yes, what is it, sir?
I reset my phone.
Oh, good.
No, what did he say?
He resetted his phone.
Oh, you reset it? Oh, I thought you messed up.
No. I had too much things, mm-hmm. so I had to reset it.
Reset, okay.
Well, that's sort of good, but...
So now I have more space.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Es muy probable...
Que un trabajador...
Empedernido... Nunca vea...
El fruto...
Sí, joven. ¿Tú quieres que yo vaya ahí afuera?
No
debes de ir sin zapatos.
Down. Come on.
Es muy probable
que un trabajador
empedernido
nunca vea
el fruto
de su labor
porque su empleo
consume
todo su tiempo
y energías.
Eclesiastes
dice
que eso es
tan absurdo
como tratar
de atrapar
el viento.
La Biblia
lo ayudará
a ver
su empleo
con equilibrio.
Es verdad
que debemos
trabajar
con empeño.
Pero
la palabra de Dios también
nos recuerda
que hay que
asegurarnos
de las cosas
más
importantes.
Filipenses 1:10.
¿Cuáles son
algunas de ellas?
Dedicar tiempo
a la familia
y los amigos
y más importante aún a los asuntos espirituales
como
leer la Biblia
y meditar en ella.
Las personas que llevan una vida equilibrada disfrutan mucho más de su trabajo. William nos cuenta, uno de mis anteriores jefes es un excelente ejemplo de cómo ser equilibrado.
Trabaja mucho
y tiene muy contentos
a sus clientes
por la calidad
de
sus servicios. Pero cuando termina el día,
sabe dejarlo
todo
atrás
y concentrarse en su familia y en su religión. Y la verdad es que es
una de las personas
más felices
que conozco.
¿Qué ves en la foto?
De
repente el muchacho está trabajando vendiendo frutas.
Generalmente cuando es de paquete pequeño.
Y me sorprende,
y entonces,
como que no es el mismo muchacho, pero aquí... ¿Ese es el mismo? Muy bien. Ahora está con su familia, ¿ves? Disfrutando. Eso es en la tarde. De repente la cena. Muy bien. Gracias por leer, hijo. Sí, me voy a cortar el pelo ya.
Le pagan como 10 o 12.